Hi, I'm Sean Martin, president and founder of Donek Snowboards. About 4 weeks ago, I got the opportunity to see a plate system from those guys up in Canada. And I got the chance to actually ride a plate system that most people don't know exist. I was completely blown away by the performance. The stability that it adds to the board is amazing. I was riding faster and feeling more comfortable than I think I ever have. I couldn't feel the icy, chopped up terrain that I was on. I felt incredibly comfortable on it. So I started thinking, how can I make something like this? And began making sketches and trying to figure out what I could do to make an extremely simple plate. It's not my goal to make a $1,000 plate. It's my goal to make a plate that just about anybody can afford, hopefully, and feel what I was able to feel. So what I've done, and mind you, this is a prototype. This is the first one. We started on this about 4 days ago. This is just a wood core with fiberglass top and bottom. Right now it's got a clear top sheet on it so you can see what's going on. It's got inserts for mounting your bindings. It's also got inserts for mounting hardware on the opposite side of the core. And some through holes for accessing components that get mounted underneath the plate. We are using a hole pattern. I believe it's similar to the Canadian hole pattern. And we will be attempting to adapt a plate to work on a 4x4, I think. But at this point, this is the most convenient way to do it. So I'm going to go ahead and mount this to the board and show you what it looks like when it's mounted and what a plate system actually does when it's working. Oh, our total weight here on all the components for this very first prototype is about 5.9 pounds. Presumably we'll be able to shave off some of that weight. I've already identified some areas where we can. There's a couple components here that are fixes to problems that occurred that we didn't anticipate on our first build. And we'll go ahead and compensate for those in future designs. That's just about it. I'll go ahead and start assembling it. Unfortunately, at this point, we're having to use a 4mm flathead screw. It's the only way we could get the clearance. But hopefully, in the future, we will find a way to go to a 5mm. Problem is, a 5mm has a button head or a raised head on it, so we have a little bit of clearance issue. And that results in a taller stack. So right now we'll be using a 4mm, but hopefully we can... Okay, so all mounted up. Now, like I said, we've got a pivot back here and a slider up here. So when we flex the board, we're going to see that the front end slides. And you can see a little bit of motion there. And the back end stays fixed. Essentially, what that does for us is allows the board to flex completely naturally underneath us and keeps our stance and feet in that fixed position we've spent so much time trying to develop. We spend all this time and energy developing and figuring out what our angles should be, what our cants should be, how our boots should be set up. And then on a typical snowboard, we get into a turn and the board bends. And what happens? All those cants and all those angles change. Well, our body adapts. But when we hit something irregular in the snow, it changes very, very rapidly. And that throws us for a big loop. By doing something like this, our stance stays static. It never moves. We become very, very stable. And what's going on with the board underneath us as a result of uneven terrain, as a result of ice, as a result of big balls of ice or whatever we might hit, is just going on with the board. It's not happening to us anymore. It just happens to the board. So this is an incredible advancement. It's incredibly amazing the performance you can gain from something like this. We're going to go up and test this on Thursday at A Basin for the first time. And possibly a couple times next week. And hopefully we'll be able to release something for you next season that you can afford to buy and that can really enhance your riding experience.